Maybe when I was about 16 or something, I bought one of the Fela records. I mean, I think I bought Zombie. And I mean, somebody told me that there's this artist who makes like really long songs, and the intro is like only like 5 minutes or 10 minutes. And I was like interested, what is it? And then I found Fela's records. And I mean, after that, yeah, I've been quite a big fan. I made a lot of tracks for this album, and I think some of the stuff where I sang, we didn't put them on the album. And I don't know, I've been playing more saxophone these days and flute. And I don't know, most of my albums, there are not so many vocal tracks. Like my first two albums, there was one vocal track on each, so it's not so new. I mean, I do sing in this one, at least on one track. When we go live, I sing because we have some of the old songs. And, I mean, live I sing a bit more than on the albums.
Are you going to work further with Kamu Kamu?
Yeah, I think so. We're kind of like married now, so I mean, there's no return. Yeah, I mean, we have fun, so. And, you know, I need to, I have responsibility. I have to keep the band guys working. I don't know, I just listen to records, you know. But, I mean, nowadays you can go to the YouTube, there's some amazing stuff, you know, like, just, you know, like this. So I just went a couple of days ago, some really interesting thing. I mean, what's the other way? I mean, unless you travel somewhere in Africa, but it's quite far and expensive. Records.
But you have to listen to them live, or it's okay to listen to the
recordings?
Recordings.
I guess it has to be okay to listen to a recording. I mean, why not? I mean, a lot of times I get like mixtapes or, you know, mix CDs somebody sends me. I mean, a lot of the stuff I find like that. So I'm not like a record collector. I just listen to music, you know. Many times it's compilations and things like that. I don't know. I guess if you're honest in your music, then it doesn't go out of fashion. I mean, that's my guess. And what's guaranteed to go out of fashion is that if you follow the fashion, what's going on at the moment, and then you kind of like copy the hip thing, that's guaranteed to fail, you know. But you know, I think high quality stuff is always good. Love never goes out of fashion. I mean, if you sing about love and all these things, it's guaranteed to work. Although I don't sing so much about love, but enough. Well, there hasn't been so many strange things. On the other hand, every show is a very strange experience. I mean, like, I hopefully try to, you know, baffle the people a little bit with the gigs. Like, what is weird? I mean, nothing is weird. Have you seen something weird? Like, I can't recall anything. Maybe kind of like a bit melancholic thing, you know, like maybe a bit strange, you know, like Finnish people don't normally say anything, you know, like if Finnish people are in a radio interview, they might say like, you know, I've seen that. But yeah, also I like, you know, the typical stuff, like going to the sauna and, you know, because I used to live in Spain quite a long time, and in here there's only like gay sauna, and for me it's like, what? There's, you know, like what's so gay about sauna? You know, everybody in Finland is a macho thing, you know, like all the truck drivers and stuff, they all go to sauna and they talk about, you know, ice hockey and things like this. So I'm a little bit like that, although I don't talk about ice hockey.